I'm Chris and I do things the fucked up way.
I know, right? Weird way. I don't laugh like that, though.
What episode is this? What episode is this?
109.
Romo, be our guest.
He's trying to charge his old ass Android over there. His Nokia.
Look at him, look at him.
Yeah.
I purposely bought a shitty Android charger.
It looks super ripped.
It was charging fast earlier. Oh, it was. What is this?
Episode 109.
Hey.
In this episode, we're gonna talk about.
You know what I'm gonna do one day? I'm gonna cut all the times that you say the episode number, and I'm gonna make it like a counting video for kids. 1, 2, 3, 45, 49. No, just kidding. Sound like Seinfeld. All right, so we're doing finding the positivity and stuff, right? Because
yeah, we're gonna do, looking for the positive in everything as opposed to the negative. I don't know what you talk about. I guess you talk about being an optimist as opposed to being a pessimist.
Glass half full, baby.
Instead of half empty. You know what I'm saying? Like,
because we're designed to look at the negative. That's constant keeping us in a certain vibration.
Well, no. I don't think we're designed. I think the world conditions us, and sadly, the people abusing our trust, abusing our kindness. You know, that turns us into suspicious individuals, distrusting individuals. You know what I'm saying? That turns us into people who, when we meet someone, instead of trying to say, "Oh, this seems like a nice person." Well, I'm actually start thinking, how could they screw me over? How could they, you know, try to, are they being two-faced? You know what I'm saying? Like, right away, you start thinking that kind of stuff, you know? And that is, once again, I guess that goes more towards being a pessimist than being an optimist. You know what I'm saying?
Right. But why do you feel like that we do that?
Because it's portrayed to us in all media like that. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? And think about it, bro. Like, I'm a person, you know, like, who's read books since I was a little kid. And I'm telling you, bro, in books, you know, you're pretty much told how someone thinks. You know, you're reading about it. And in books, so many people automatically. Like, for example, I read Sherlock Holmes. I've read more than half of his stories.
There's a lot of inner dialogue.
Yeah, and a lot of that is, you have to suspect people. You know, a lot of times the story's not interesting unless there's a mystery. Same thing with the movie, you know. It's not interesting unless there's a mystery, you know. So
unless there's a bad guy.
It's automatically you got to try and figure out who should we suspect? Right. Is there a mole here? You know what I'm saying? You're like a true detective. You know what I'm saying? Right away, you got to find out what's going on. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I was like, I got a coworker who, I'm not gonna say her name, but one time she told me that.
So Rachel?
She, Monica, TV. So she watches a lot of those murder mystery shows.
Yeah, there's a whole
serial killer shows and all that shit, right? So one time she was at the gym. I don't even know if it was nighttime, but she was like,
she met a serial killer.
Nah, she was walking to her car, and this guy was, like, walking, like, just kind of close to her. Like, his car was right there. And she was like, ah. And she screamed, don't rape me.
She literally did that?
Yeah.
And what'd the guy do?
He's like, whoa, I'm not gonna fucking rape you. I'm not a rapist.
I'm not.
And that shit is, like, she's so traumatized by the shows that she's thinking, like, oh, this guy who just, like, looks like a regular dude is gonna fucking do the worst possible thing.
That's how it is. I mean, especially as a woman in this world, I can imagine you do have to suspect everybody of doing shit, you know? So many, you know, like, look at how the world is, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not like they're just paranoid for nothing, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of women are mistreated pretty badly around the world, you know what I'm saying? Like. Yeah. And yeah, you know, like, women can't get mugged, you know, can't get kidnapped, you know what I'm saying? So, of course, you know, it is understandable that, you could say that the media did it too, but it's also, like, it's a combination of the media over it. Like, we're supposed to be wary of what we're doing, right? It's not like you're not supposed to, like, be going on aware of your surroundings of what's going on, right? Situational awareness, you know?
Right.
But
like I always like to live a little bit like you're in an action movie. But could always happen, so you always keep...
Yeah, think about when you're a kid. You see a scary movie, every corner you go around, you think it's going to be there. That's the same thing with why people, like you said, why most women are, like, in the parking lot, this guy's following me, he's going to rape me or try to kidnap me, because of what you see on TV. Like you said, all those shows, they take that paranoia and they dial it up, you know what I'm saying? To the very worst can happen, and look, it happened to this person, you know what I'm saying? Like, but half the time, I bet those stories...
She's a normal person, just like you.
I bet half the time those stories are all bullshit, bro.
Oh, I'm sure they're enhanced and made, like, even more interesting, and they spread, and it's hilarious to me, Because my mom watches some of the detective shows, or like the Files, like the, where it's like it's almost hacking tech. Like it to me is like it's hilarious how mysterious they're being before the commercial break. They're like, so he confessed that he killed him, but did he really? And then like commercials, I don't know, some stupid shit like that. So yeah, like that's really pushed.
I mean, think about it, you know, the study of like of criminals, like for example, the interrogation room. You know, people love watching that
48
shit.
48 hours.
Yeah, people love watching that shit. You know what I'm saying? And
they always snitch.
And you're watching that show like, that guy's lying. I bet he's lying. Look, you know what I'm saying? Like, you automatically start being suspect because that's their job. Their job, those guys in the interrogation room, is to suspect every single thing that comes out of your mouth and every single thing you do. You know what I'm saying? So you take on that role yourself. You know
and
what
even
I mean?
And we know as Americans, we know that our leaders are corrupt. We know politicians are corrupt, so we don't trust...
Whoa, sir, I trust my local politicians with my livelihood, sir.
I don't know if there's ever been, like, a mass trusting of government ever.
1776.
Maybe that was the only time. when you had all the gangsters, all the OGs and shit in Congress. The
Founding Fathers.
Yeah, the Founding Fathers.
I mean, you would have to look at, like, Reagan and them, too.
But there was Reaganomics, so there's a whole population of people that didn't like Reagan.
There's a whole population didn't like some of
Reaganomics. Reaganomics was based on a lot of propaganda. We know another president who's been just beat down with propaganda, and none of that shit is true.
Because you know what's interesting is like it's almost like a double negative, because if it wasn't for Reagan made it easier for my dad to come and get citizenship.
It ain't not.
Right.
That's a double negative. It ain't not.
Kennedy.
Huh?
Oh, I thought you were talking about quote.
Nah, that's a double negative is what he's saying. You ain't not nothing. That means that you're something, right? You ain't not nothing. Is that right?
You ain't not nothing. Yeah, it means you are something. Yeah.
You ain't not nothing, man. But yeah, like, I think even like the Bible, like half of humanity is good, half of it's bad, like the way they do the Cain and Abel. Like this dude would kill his own brother. You know what I mean? So you're just brought up as a kid listening to these stories like, what? You can't even trust your brother? Like, that's instinct. Like, that starts, like, it's somewhere.
You're taught to distrust the world around you.
Right.
You know, almost by design.
Right. In Genesis, when that old dude goes in the cave with his two daughters, I don't know if you know about that story, and then they get him drunk and have sex with him because they couldn't have kids with anybody else for some reason because they were away from population.
That story has got to be very misconstrued.
I think it was just adding in, bro, one day, like, for no reason.
One day, I'm gonna come across something, I think, that's gonna explain that to me.
Yeah. Because my sister just listened to it recently, and she was like, what the fuck is that? And I was like,
okay, if it doesn't vibe with you, you need to skip it.
Right.
That's what I would say. Right. Don't keep it in your head.
And that's what, what is it, like, constructive thinking? No, critical thinking.
Yeah.
Where you can take something and not dismiss the entirety of it because one part is bullshit.
See, and that's why...
accept that bullshit just because other parts are positive.
That's why the reading and writing session of those tests we took growing up are important. Learning to read a story or something and taking that information to formulate is important. It's a life skill.
If you can actually comprehend it. A lot of people can't comprehend.
It's a life skill.
Shit.
But, you know, like sometimes, I have a co-worker too. Who sometimes, you know, what they'll do is they'll take one bad thing that happens to them or one thing that doesn't go their way, one bad day.
And, I forgot what we were talking about.
And all of a sudden, you know, all these other things start coming out like the stuff you spend time pushing down, like that you're a loser, that you're gonna be alone forever, that nobody wants you. Those thoughts, you spend time pushing them down, but then this other thing really throws you off, and then now they come out and they're beating the shit out of you.
And
you know
Katrina
what I'm saying?
Hits the levees, and then
and they're beating the shit out of you, and now you start to think, man, I don't deserve to live. I'm a piece of shit. I really am nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, you start to believe all these things all because of one thing. And so you. Instead of,
you know what? At least you don't eat babies.
And we talked about it, it's like chess. You know, it's not the first blunder that gets you. You can have a bad day, some shit can go not your way, but it's that second time where you just end up making a mistake because you just gave up. You know what I'm saying? You can't give up.
Yeah.
You know, you always have to try to find like for example, everyone knows this. Well, most everyone, you know, they do. You learn more from your bad days and bad moments than you do from your good ones, for the most part. You know what I'm saying? So if you're having a bad day or if you did something stupid, instead of yes, trying to dwell on the fact that I did something stupid or didn't go my way, try to find a lesson in this so you can go ahead and get done with this. Wrap it up, throw it away.
You always gotta be like, also, like, in my head, I'm always like, well, at least that didn't happen. I always think about the worst possible outcome.
See, there you go. See?
And I'm like, well, fuck.
And why do you do that? Why do you do that?
I feel like it's OCD or anxiety.
Are you addicted to just making yourself feel, like, stressed out? That's what I'm saying.
Maybe.
Exactly. See, we do it to ourselves.
But
see?
It also helps be like, well, at least that didn't happen. You know?
At least that didn't happen. Yeah. At least I'm not dead. You know what I'm saying? Like,
at least I didn't kill anybody. You know? Certain things like that. But, alright, what helps me out also, and I brought this up because it's a big part of my life at my job, work with this 4-year-old blind kid.
Oh, man, this kid.
He can't see nothing, right? So he don't know colors, bro. Just the fact that we can see colors, man. The fact that we can walk around, you just gotta appreciate the literature, bro. Because convenience we talked about before, like how convenience took away curiosity. Convenience also took away our ability to look for positivity. Like, when people lived in strife, constantly having to hunt, seeing a butterfly was an amazing thing. Now that everything's so easy and peaceful and calm.
When you're sitting there laid back and you're watching a YouTube video, you're on your favorite app and whatnot, and someone says anything to you, like, hey, you want to get something to eat? Because you're so comfy and lazy, you'd be like, I think I'm good. You know what I'm saying? Like.
And it's so good now. We got it so good. Society, there's never been a society that has it this good, like this rich, that we start looking for negative and nothing for some reason.
Yeah.
And where there is no, we start reaching and pulling for things that don't exist.
You have it so good that you just start feeling like, you know what? I got it too good. I need some drama in my life. Right. I need some.
Let me find somebody on the internet to debate about because they're on.
Let me find a flashback that's gonna cause me stress and start, you know, because I wanna be unhappy.
Right.
You know.
Yeah.
How do you deal with that kind of shit, Roman?
Tell you?
How you deal with that kind of shit?
No, I mean, like, say what you just said.
Say the entire thing.
Oh, God. What did I just say?
How do you not know
what I just said?
Well, how do you look for the positive? What helps you look for the positive? What reminds you to look for the positive whenever you're negative?
Hey, what did I just say?
For me personally, I just look at... I just flip everything. I flip all the negative words that I say to myself now. I just try to say good things and try not to be so negative. When I'm feeling negative, I just start saying, you know, like, well, could be worse, could be this, you know, at least you woke up, you know, you were able to at least have a job, you know, you have good friends all around you, you know, you start kind of pulling good things that you've done out of like a little jar that you have of accomplishments.
Exactly.
Over the years or whatever you've done. Like, for one, if I can make somebody smile, or just crack a joke at somebody if I see that they're having a bad day, yeah, bring my day up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Or
is that serotonin?
You see the good in others.
Is that serotonin?
Yeah.
Dopamine? I forget which one it is.
Both.
The one that made the you get from helping people. Whatever, if you want, keep on.
Also, I remind myself of the leadership role that I'm trying to take, that people feed off of my energy. So if I'm feeling down and negative, they're gonna feel it as well. So
right.
I try to look at the good thing. You know, even...
Because you're lucky to be in that position.
Pretty much.
Some people would kill to be in that position.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just not in it.
Some people just are all talk, too. You know, at least I'm being about it.
Right.
And trying to change it.
Right.
And, yeah, I mean, that's the way I try to deal with it. For the most part.
Yeah, man, it's to be honest, sometimes it's hard to be... It can be hard to be negative.
It can be hard to be negative.
Like when I'm on cloud 9.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
When I'm blazed.
I know what you mean. Oh.
You know what I mean?
But I shouldn't need substances to be.
I shouldn't need substances, but.
It helps.
He's not lying.
Yeah, it helps find the positivity. Just like it helps find the curiosity.
But sometimes, wouldn't you agree that sometimes that's false then? It's not true.
Well, we have those, for some reason, those things for the chemicals to connect to, right? I don't know what it's called.
You know, one thing.
You're not abusing it, in a sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like,
as long as you're still being productive, you're kind of using it as, like, for medicinal uses.
Yeah, as long as you ain't sitting there smoking a half or ounce a week, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Right.
But one thing I like to do, you know, when I know that I know I'm in a bad mood, I know all the thoughts I'm having are negative, and I'm just irritable as can be, I take it to God, because he, you know, that's really, you know, right. Basically what that does for me is just like, okay, God, is this legit or is this just me, my ego? You know what I'm saying? It's just me having my head up my ass. You know what I'm saying? And hey, man, real talk. Most times it just turns out to be that, hey, man, you're blowing something up, got your head up your ass, you know what I'm saying? This is all ego, you know, it's pride, whatnot, you know what I'm saying? You need to eat some humble pie and just carry on, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, charge it to the game.
Yes, I like that. Charge it to the game, man. Charge it to the game.
That's what you gotta do. We always say that, like, whenever a blunt will spill or something will fuck, man, just charge it.
When you break a bone.
It's taxes to the world, man. It's like a little sacrifice to the universe, like. Goes back to whence it came. Now, if you keep doing that shit, then you're out the crew. Nah.
And you know what, bro? Like, God would never turn his back on anybody. God would never cut you off and say, you know what? You've messed up too many times. I'm not going to be your friend anymore.
Right.
God would never do that. You know what I'm saying? And that's one thing people need to practice. Obviously, there's a difference between people who just leech off you and people who do take advantage of you. You know what I'm saying?
Preview to a future podcast. Really? Friends.
Oh, we doing that?
Friends. At some point, I don't know when. I think it's a good topic, though.
Could be.
God is your friend.
We haven't done a friends one? Man, that seems like it's an easy topic to do, right?
Yeah, I just thought about it.
But, don't forget it. I'm a genius. What we at right now? 30 minutes?
16.
Already, bro. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's just...
I think what a lot of people have trouble doing is trying to find that good, like, in a certain
bad. Oh, I forgot to say, too.
The power of just saying, you know, like, when something negative pops up, like, we miss, like, at work, like, we'll miss a train. Like, just at work, if we miss a train, that means the next week is probably going to, throughout the week, it's going to be a little bit more heavier than normal.
Yep.
You know, instead of looking at it like, oh, fuck, you should look at it like, well, good, I'm going to get some more overtime.
I've got work, you know.
It's always a positive. I was also gonna say, like, the country we live in.
Or instead of, like, looking at it like that, you gotta say, well, good, that means let me get off early. You know? It's also that, too.
Right.
Just for that day and then the rest of the week, you know, you got a good positive vibe.
You know, it's like, you want your emotions to be swole, right? Well, look, it don't take nothing. Like being negative is like picking up little 2-pound weights, you know what I'm saying? But being positive, trying to put a positive thought in your head and going with it, that's like picking up 15, 20, 35, 40-pound weights, you know what I'm saying?
And the more you force yourself the easier
it'll be to look on the bright. Everything is practice. The more you practice looking on the bright side, the more you practice trying to find the lesson and everything so I can get done with the bullshit that I'm going through. The easier it gets. It's like little cheat codes, man, but it's that thing. It's learning to know yourself and controlling your emotions. You know what I'm saying? Right. Know
it's that. Like if we are like the Sims, if we are like in the Matrix, those words are like cheat codes, like you said, and enhance our mood. Because if you start thinking negative shit, your mind is fucking powerful. You start thinking it, you start feeling it. Like me, when I think the extreme thing, like, whoa, that could have been that, but... Oh, but I was gonna say, where we live, you gotta appreciate, and you know, the media will try to make you hate where you try to hate the country that you live in, which is bananas because you have the ability to talk shit about it and not get locked up. Which in many countries, you talk shit about your own country.
You appreciate where you live. Appreciate where you live, bro.
Where you can still get rich off of your own original idea.
You can, bro.
Right,
can.
And take care of your family. Like, it's still possible.
Yeah, we were talking about yesterday how curiosity has made everybody the same. So originality is so rare. So if it's rare, then right now originality is worth even more than ever.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, we're sitting on gold, you know, over here maybe. You know what I'm saying? With this shit, you know, if you get that sticker processor thing, whatever, man, come on, man, we get this going. Remember, we talked about yesterday, we could have Oz Squad Empire. You know what I'm saying? We could have if the Oz Squad Chess channel kicks off, we got that going. You know what I'm saying? You know, we
iPod for kids. I have a kids channel with little puppets and shit, man.
Nah, because then people start to think we're on the pedo side. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to get this. I don't want no one thinking we're doing that. You know?
That's true. iPod pets. We'll have like dogs and cats and shit. No, I'm just kidding.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, but yeah. I'm just trying to joke around.
If we can get that weed from Colorado, we go ahead and have a name for it, the iPod Farm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We have our own damn weed brand, bro. Whoa. Think about how badass that would be, our own damn sponsor.
And it's possible. We can dream in America because we've seen it happen. It can happen. And, you know, hopefully
for
the rest of our lives, it'll still be that way. But every day you have to appreciate that freedom.
Hell yeah, bro.
As long as we can see it. We can go and basically achieve it. I know it's a cliche.
Every day is a gift, you know.
Man, we're not gonna break this up.
Isn't that why they what they call it?
A present.
They call it a present.
The present.
They call it the present, right? Isn't that?
We done.
Isn't that? You know what I'm saying?
You gotta celebrate.
And tomorrow, you never know.
I don't think we said it right.
Yesterday, hey man, that's the past. Today's the gift, the present, man. Tomorrow, you never know. So what are you tripping for? You know what I'm saying? What are you tripping for?
It had one from like his tea, but he kind of wrapped it up differently. He said,
let's do it.
He said that the tea bag thing, you know, he has a little notes. Dog, shit, I'm losing it. He said problems are only in your head, right? So just forget them.
That's literally what it said?
No.
That's not
what he said.
Oh, Lord.
And I thought I remember being I built it up too much.
We could have ended this on some wisdom.
I'm building it up too much.
We're just fucking it up right now. It sounded like some wannabes. Let's just go ahead and end it, man.
21.
All
right, see y'all next time.
Yay.
Peace.